My brother, the people have chosen you and have affirmed their trust in you by acclaiming your election. A bishop in God's holy church is called to be one with the apostles in proclaiming Christ's resurrection and interpreting the gospel, and to testify to Christ's sovereignty as Lord of Lords and King of Kings. You are called to guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church, to celebrate and provide for the administration of the sacraments of the new covenant, to ordain priests and deacons, and to join in ordaining bishops, and to be in all things a faithful pastor and wholesome example for the entire flock of Christ. With your fellow bishops, you will share in the leadership of the church throughout the world. Your heritage is a faith of patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and those of every generation who have looked to God in hope. Your joy will be to follow him who came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. Are you persuaded that God has called you to the office of bishop?
I am so persuaded.
Will you accept this call and fulfill this trust in obedience to Christ?
I will obey Christ and will serve in his name.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the study of Holy Scripture, that you may have the mind of Christ?
I will, for he is my help.
Will you boldly proclaim and interpret the gospel of Christ, enlightening the minds and stirring up the conscience of your people?
I will, in the power of the Spirit.
As a chief priest and pastor, will you encourage and support all baptized people in their gifts and ministries, nourish them from the riches of God's grace, pray for them without ceasing, and celebrate with them the sacraments of our redemption?
I will, in the name of Christ, the shepherd and bishop of our souls.
Will you guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church?
I will, for the love of God.
Will you share with your fellow bishops in the government of the whole church? Will you sustain your fellow presbyters and take counsel with them? Will you guide and strengthen the deacons and all others who minister in the church?
I will, by the grace given.
Will you be merciful to all, show compassion to the poor and strangers, and defend those who have no helper?
I will, for the sake of Christ Jesus.
Edward, through these promises, you have committed yourself to God to serve his church in the office of bishop. We therefore call upon you, chosen to be a guardian of the church's faith, to lead us in confessing that faith.
We believe in one God.
Begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all comfort, dwelling on high but having regard for the lowly, knowing all things before they come to pass, we give you thanks that from the beginning you have gathered and prepared a people to be heirs of the covenant of Abraham, and have raised up prophets, kings, and priests, never leaving your temple untended. We praise you also that from the creation you have graciously accepted the ministry of those whom you have chosen. Therefore, Father, make Edward a bishop in your church, pour out upon him the power of your princely spirit, whom you bestowed upon your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, with whom he endowed the apostles, and by whom your church is built up in every place, to the glory and unceasing of your name. To you, O Father, all hearts are open. Fill, we pray, the heart of this your servant, whom you have chosen to be a bishop in your church, with such love of you and of all the people, that he may feed and tend the flock of Christ and exercise without reproach the high priesthood to which you have called him, serving before you day and night in the ministry of reconciliation, declaring pardon in your name, offering the holy gifts, and wisely overseeing the life and work of the church. In all things may he present before you the acceptable offering of a pure and gentle and holy life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, with power in the church, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Edward, receive the Holy Scriptures. Feed the flock of Christ committed to your charge. Guard and defend them in his truth. And be a faithful steward of his holy word and sacraments. It is my joy to present to you the seventh bishop of the Diocese of Northern Indiana and his family.
Brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.